Hey everyone, if you have a fairly powerful graphics card that requires two or even three PCI Express connectors and you're powering it with a single cable by using these rubbish pigtail things, then you're probably doing it wrong. If you're getting choppy graphics in gaming or experiencing some crashes and freezing, it might be because you're not supplying enough power to your graphics card. Some people would disagree with what I'm about to say in this video, but Nvidia, Antec, Silverstone, and others all say you should be using separate PCI Express cables for your graphics card. This is certainly true if your graphics card's TDP, its rated power, is 225 watts or above. But why is this? Well, let me back up a bit. Early graphics cards were fairly low powered, and simply plugging them in was enough. This is because the PCI Express slot on your motherboard will supply around 75 watts of power. So lower powered graphics cards of old would be entirely powered by this 75 watts. However, we now expect a lot from our graphics cards, resulting in Nvidia GPUs that are now bigger than a car. Okay, that's a fake image. But in the last decades, graphics cards have got much bigger and more powerful. That means that the paltry 75 watts from the motherboard PCI Express slot is no longer sufficient. And so you need to run separate cables directly from your power supply unit to your graphics card to supply the extra power load. Here's the issue. A cable can't magically supply loads of power through it. It's a bit like electrical cables, or Romex as you'd say in America. The thicker the cable, the more power it can supply. This thinner cable is used for low voltage deliveries like lighting circuits, while this thicker cable is used for wall sockets and things like that. Now, if I wired up a wall socket with this thinner cable throughout my house and then plugged in loads of different appliances, you could start to get issues with resistance and the cable heating up, and potentially the cable could melt, which is bad. Turning back to PCI Express cables, it's thankfully unlikely that you can wire up your graphics cards so badly that the wires will melt due to all the fail-safes and protections within your PSU, motherboard, and graphics card. But if your graphics card needs two or three PCI Express connectors, it is entirely possible to supply an insufficient amount of power to your GPU by just using a single PCI Express cable, then relying on this weird pigtail connector to connect to the second PCI Express slot on your graphics card. This pigtail connector has a few names: split end, Y splitter, devil spawn, or pigtail. I'll call it pigtail for now on, but I wanted to mention the other names so that we're all on the same page about this horrible, horrible connector. Now, PCI Express cables can officially supply up to 150 watts according to the spec. Sometimes it could be more than this, but let's say it's 150 watts for now. That means that if your graphics card needs more than 225 watts of power, using a single cable will not be enough for it, because the motherboard's 75 watts and the PCI Express cable's 150 watts is less than your card's TDP. This will then result in poor gaming performance or even crashes. So what's the solution? Well, it's to run a second PCI Express cable from your power supply unit. Yes, your PSU will probably only have a single rail for the PCI Express supply, but using a second cable means you're freeing yourself of the 150 watt restriction, which exists because of the cable itself, not the PSU. In other words, the AWG thickness of the cable dictates how much power the cable can handle before resistance and heat becomes the bottleneck. By using a second cable, you're then able to supply around 300 watts of power from your PSU to your graphics card. Plus, you're getting another 75 watts from the motherboard PCI Express slot, allowing you to power cards up to 375 watts easily enough. This means that you can usually power a three connector card like the RX 7900 XT with just two separate cables. After all, it has a TDP of 355 watts, so as long as you aren't overclocking the card, you should be okay to just use two cables and then rely on the horrible pigtail connector for the third PCI Express connection. Yes, I know I called this a horrible, horrible devil spawn connector, and it kind of is because it lulls people into a false sense of security. But in this particular case, it's fairly useful, I guess. I still hate the pigtail cables though, as you can probably tell. However, if you purchase the Sapphire 7900 XTXT Nitro Plus, which is an overclocked card, two cables probably won't cut it because it has a TDP of 420 watts, meaning that two cables probably won't be enough. You should then run three separate cables to it. Notice how I said probably there? That's because while I keep saying the PCI Express cable will supply 150 watts, many good quality cables and power supplies can supply more than this, potentially 288 watts or even 400 watts for the best AWG gauge cable. This means that you might actually be able to power a 300-watt graphics card from a single PCI Express cable just by relying on the Devilspawn connector. Sorry, the pigtail connector. To be honest, though, this all gets a bit confusing, and unless you're a qualified electrical tester with a bunch of testing gear, I would probably just prefer to err on the side of caution and always use two or three separate cables so that I can ensure the most stable power delivery to my graphics card possible. The only downside of running multiple PCI Express cables is that it looks ugly. Just look at it. Those unused pigtail connectors hang around the case and just mess up the aesthetics. You can't easily hide the pigtail either behind the motherboard tray because it's only a few inches long, so it just hangs around unused, looking ugly. Luckily, there is a solution. Single connector PCI Express cables. Companies like CableMart and PSU makers like Corsair sell individual PSU cables that only have one end on them. These often come in pairs, meaning you can plug these two separate cables into your PSU and run each to your graphics card, and they end up looking a lot nicer. I'm due to publish a new video soon showing all this in more detail, but these custom or premium PCI Express cables are often individually sleeved too, allowing for a much neater finish to your cable management inside your case. Before wrapping up, there is a newer type of PCI Express cable for PCI Express version 5, and this is known as the 12-pin connector. The way these work is that you have two separate PCI Express ends that plug into the PSU, and these cables are then merged into a single connector which is plugged into your graphics card, delivering up to 600 watts in theory. These cables have been a little controversial though because some have melted. Well, not some. There have been a lot of reported cases of burnt connector ends. Putting that to one side though, you should always aim to plug these high power 12-pin connectors into two separate points on your power supply unit. Don't use some weird connector that merges them back into a single PCI Express point on your PSU. That will end badly. Bad things will happen. And that wraps up today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. While YouTube is fairly smart, it does also kind of boil down to more likes equals more exposure. If you wanted to see more videos from me, then please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.